year, my next anime review is Neon Genesis Evangelion, also known as Evangelion, Says of the Great Late Robin Williams Reset, rest in peace. It is a series created by Hideo Akiyama, also done by Studio Gainax. Neon Genesis Evangelion takes place on futuristic Tokyo, where the monster known as Angels attacks it. It focuses on a boy named Shiji Ikaru, who got invited to this organization known as NERD, created by his own father. The moment he steps into this organization, his father wants him to pilot this mecha known as Evangelion. Throughout the series, Shinji, along with Rei and Asuka, they piloted the Evangelion to fight against Angels, and this is part of what the series is about. Well, I'm not saying the series is just about mechas. The series also focuses on like other characters like life problems and other humanity aspect, but those that include realistic aspect too. Evangelion honestly is a really good series in my opinion. It is also one of the best 90s anime out there, but at the same time it also a pretty complicated and adult rated series to watch. I do like the mecha part of the series. I mean, it's really fun to look to watch, and there's a lot of exciting accents and character interesting. But then at the same time, when you look at to like the other side of the series, it says every time when Shinji thinks about his problems or thinks about his father, that part of the series really does play heavily. And there are some parts where you could either think that it's a pretty unique idea or a pretty depressing idea. Well, I mean, Hidege, I know, does have a lot of life issues, so this is one of the reasons why the series is relies heavily on that type of plot and characters. But the thing what makes the series also great too is the editing. I do like the editing and throughout the episodes. That's when you look at the title screen or when there's focus on other scenes. I think that part of the series is really good. And that's where I really like the art style to it too. The art style, in my opinion, in the series is probably one of the best art style I've seen in an anime manga series. But at the same time, there are a lot of things about the series that you could either agree or disagree. But overall, this series is a fantastic anime series to watch. It is over 26 episodes, and there's plenty of things to look forward to. Now, my opinion about the series is that the series itself does have, that's focused on a lot of different characters besides Shinji. You do get characters like Misato, who's a woman who lives with Shinji, because I mean, Shinji is obviously, well, he's not an orphan because he still has his father, but his father abandoned him when he was younger, and so obviously he doesn't have nowhere else to live or go to. Well, I mean, he does live by himself, but Misato is basically like his own guardian that takes care of him, so obviously Misato is there for him. You got Rei Ayami, who is really quiet and close-minded character. Obviously, I really do like her character. I mean, she's obviously, in my opinion, one of my personal favorite female characters in anime. And overall, it is really surprising who she is throughout near the end of the series. But I mean, once you find out, I mean, you kind of have a little what the fuck reaction when you learn about her. Asuka is not a bad character. I think she's pretty strong, especially when she pilot her Evangelion. But I feel like at times she can be a bit too self-centered, like she just thinks too much of herself. So obviously she's like a character you could have your own personal opinions on. And I do like some of the other characters too. And there's Karu, who doesn't come up until like near the end of the series. I think Karu and Shiji relationship is kind of weird, honestly. And I'm a big fan of their bond, but that's the thing, they're like character that you can't either be like, oh yeah, they're great friends, but then you think like, what the fuck are they doing? There's this man, I mean, boys, what the fuck? But overall, I think Carter is a pretty cool character, but it kind of sucks he only comes out like at least one episode. But yeah, there's that. And I obviously agree with Carter, since he's farther, he's fine pants farther the most bad parenting I've seen in anime series. I mean, there's a lot of anime with bad parents, like Fullmetal Alchemist Hunter or freaking or any other series you could think of, even Code Geass too. But I mean, yeah, anime these days, you do have like bunch of bad father or bad mother figure But overall, I think Ryukari has a pretty cool design, and obviously he does really play a big part in this whole series, so there's his presence in this throughout the series. But honestly, another thing I want to say about the series too is that the mecha acid between the Evangelion and the Angels are really amazing. I mean, if you look at how some of the fight scenes are, they could be pretty brutal, but I bet they can be pretty epic, you can say. So obviously the mecha accent in this series does pays off. I think there's a lot of memorable mecha anime series out there, and I think Evangelion is one of them that could count as being one of the all-time greats in this genre. But at the same time too, when you look at the mecha part of the series, there's also that human drama in the series too. I mean, human drama series practically what makes the series where it is, because obviously the creator, like I said earlier, he has problems, and I guess you could say they kind of affects us too. We're humans, we have personal issue, bad connections with other people, maybe some parts of us that we can't really expand more on. But obviously the series does really play a lot on that type of storytelling too. And as well as explaining what are these angels and all of these type of religions. I mean, there's a lot of religion expert in this series too, so obviously there's like a lot of things that goes on in this series that does make sense, and part that doesn't make as much sense that you were thought it would be. So obviously it is a series that kind of requires a few multiple viewings in order to understand a bit more. So obviously it's a really really deep series, I gotta be honest about. But overall, what I do also like about this series too is that it does make a huge impact in the anime industry. So that said, the characters and the genre it has. I mean, there's like a lot of things that you could say that it plays a huge important part of anime, and as well it has a really iconic opening theme too. I think the opening theme to this series is really good, and it's probably one of the most memorable anime opening I've ever seen. And overall, I think Neon Genesis Evangelion, or Evangelion also, is a really good series. It is obviously my top three favorite mega anime, and also one of my personal favorites too. So overall, Neon Genesis Evangelion, in my opinion, is a fantastic series to watch. I mean, my main problem about the series has to be the ending. The ending felt out of place, and I think in my opinion, the ending, you could look at it, you could think it was a great ending or a terrible ending. I thought that the ending wasn't that great, but that's why they did the two films, especially in Evangelion, and then they did the rebuild of Evangelion film series, which still needs to have its fourth film release. So overall, there's like a few things among the series besides the original 26 episode series that aired in Japan back in 1995. So overall, Neon Genesis Evangelion, really good series, and I give this anime series an A. Thank you for watching my video. Look forward to more of my anime reviews, and as well as have a good day.